Our three children are 5, 9 and 11. I have been trying to find appointments for all three children in various spots, but it isn't easy.
Parents like Georgie Dent are eager to get their children vaccinated.
The kids are actually, I would say, more anxious now about contracting the virus than they have been. They have been asking us to make sure we get them vaccinated as soon as possible.
Told they could book their kids' vaccine appointments from late December.
People have had a bit of time now to get organised. I think things are set well, and I'm looking forward to seeing that get off to a smooth start.
But for many parents and carers, landing an appointment has been anything but smooth.
There are very few clinics that have online appointments available. It's not necessarily straightforward to try and find three appointments on the same day.
GPs also reporting limited vaccine appointments as child jabs clash with adults getting their boosters.
Some people have had their appointments cancelled because chemists are concerned that vaccines won't arrive as promised.
In Australia, there are more than 2.2 million children aged between 5 and 11. In New South Wales, in the last week alone, there were more than 7,200 positive cases in kids aged 9 and under. By the end of the school term last year, this age group made up about 20% of all infections.
Hopefully they'll be vaccinated, the majority of them, before they go back to school.
But estimates show only around 1/3 of children will have had their first dose before school goes back.
As a mother of two young boys, I'm very keen to have my boys vaccinated. There need to be plans put in place and there need to be clear strategies moving forward.
So as COVID records continue to tumble and the new school year looms, are we now in a race to vaccinate our kids?
Dr. Andrew Miller has been calling for kids to get vaccinated as soon as possible. He joins us now. Andrew, school's back in just a few weeks' time. Is it a race?
Oh, it is absolutely a race, Hamish. Disappointingly, we didn't do what the US did and start jabbing kids on the day the vaccine was approved back in November. We are having another stroll out. But our kids are our most precious resource. They have their entire future ahead of them in terms of if they get severe disease or long COVID. Really important that we protect them before they get hit by the Omicron wave.
Andrew, I'm just mindful that there'll be a lot of parents watching this interview, probably sitting at home with kids as well, thinking about the prospect of returning to school. It is true, though, isn't it, that COVID hospitalisation has disproportionately been around adults, people with comorbidities, that actually for young Australians below the age of 18, there has been very little evidence of kids being in hospital, having to go into ICU, furthermore, having to be ventilated?
Well, Hamish, around the world, we are seeing that children do get affected by this virus. We can't hide from that fact. And we're seeing record hospitalisations happening in places like New York. Although it's unusual, yes, they can get severely ill. Unfortunately, some children can die from it. And we don't know yet about the many years of long COVID ahead for a proportion of these kids, although the researchers are really worried about it. So all we're talking about now is timing. No one's arguing that they shouldn't be vaccinated. My argument is they should be vaccinated before they get the disease that can, in some children, cause problems. Now, there's a lot of vulnerable kids out there. There's a lot of kids with disabilities and long-term disease, just as there are adults. And they are every bit as precious as every other child. So we need to protect them particularly. They should be at the front of the queue. And all of this should have been done months ago so that those parents aren't anxious. And I appreciate that they are. But I think that by translating that anxiety into pressure on government to do something, pressure on schools to be safer, then we can have a positive outcome from that anxiety rather than people just being worried, because we do know the vaccine will be very protective.
Well, obviously, in the few weeks that are left, we're not going to get to that high percentage of kids being double-dosed before school returns. So should we be delaying the return to the classroom?
Well, that's a tricky one. As you know, it probably comes down to individual family circumstances, but there should be options there for parents. We should seriously look at reducing the interval between doses for children, just as we have done for the booster for adults, so that they can get their second dose more quickly. And we certainly shouldn't be forcing people to be taking their kids along to infected schools, because that's just going to create chaos and disruption for families who then have to go off, and who knows when they're going to be able to get a rapid antigen test themselves to find out whether they're infected in their own home. So in order to avoid chaos, there should be flexibility in the system, compassion in the system, and an understanding that this is a once-in-a-lifetime, very unusual event, We need to protect these kids with vaccine before they get exposed to the disease wherever possible. My view is if you tell your average kid that your school holidays are going to be extended by a week or two so that you can be protected from COVID, you'll get a thumbs up from a lot of them.
Dr. Andrew Millett, thanks for your time tonight.
Always good to talk to you. Thank you.